Okay, well, it's painfully obvious, it's just I'm a thicky, thicky borrow borrow. So, let's fucking try presenting the fucking moss here, shall we? Objection. No, still not it. Did I present it there or did I present it in the before thing? I can't fucking remember. Well, I'm just saying, he had to go fucking bury it. But there's two bits of evidence that fucking... What am I going with? The fucking raincoat? Objection. No? Do I have to give the orb another crack? Okay, let's try the fucking orb again! Again, I've got three bits of evidence to say exactly the same thing, but no, it's not good enough. Objection. Oh, fuck off! They say exactly the same thing! Don't blame yourself, Sarge. After all, even if you hadn't passed out, the outcome would have been the same. What do you mean? I'm talking about the time of death. Your father wasn't killed right after you left your room. But what? Explain yourself at once, Private Justice! You said you saw your father burning the orb, right? But that night, he went out to hide it in a cave. So, what you saw, Sarge, was something that happened before your father left to hide the orb. Ah! So you see, you didn't pass out right before he was killed. You passed out right before he left for the cave to hide the orb in the ruins within. So, even if I hadn't passed out... That's right. The outcome would have been exactly the same. That's because your father, Dr. Buff, was killed after he returned from the ruins. And therefore, Sarge, there's no need for you to blame yourself. Oh, I see. Private Justice, can you really say I bear no blame in this? Why do you ask? Because the truth is, if I hadn't engaged in my siege defense, Papa would still be alive. Sarge. Papa wished nothing more than for me to lead a happy, healthy life. That's why he quit his job and moved us out away from the big city. But even then, I didn't have the courage to set foot into the outside world. And in the end, I failed to make Papa's wish come true. Wow, that's fucking sad, man. I get that, though. I've been there. It's brutal. Well, not the whole dad dying thing. Well, sort of, in my own way. But, yeah. The whole shutting thing, kind of fucking with family members. I'm with you, kid! I'm with you! I wish I had a fucking drone that could fire missiles, though. That would have made my life a lot happier. Sarge? If you want to make your father's wish come true, if that's what you really want, then who's to say it's too late? Why don't you take the first step now? My first step? That's right. You can cast off all your regret. You can stop standing still and start moving forward. You have the power within you. I know from experience. I know what it's like to feel like you do. But only you can decide to take that first step. If you don't change your tactics now, Sarge, the victory you seek in the war you're waging will always lie beyond your grasp. I think I understand now. I've made up my mind! As of this moment, I will suspend my siege defense indefinitely. Good for you, kid. Oh, that's different. Huh? So Sergeant Buff, reporting for duty. What? I thought you were a guy. You're definitely not the gruff drill sergeant I envisioned. Well, my mama was in the Russian army. Oh, that explains a lot. I was just as shocked, but it certainly explained a few things when I found out, too. May I introduce you to Miss Army Buff, age 12. Alright, she's pretty fucking adorable, I must say. No way. Careful, soldier! Don't forget I could blow you away at a moment's notice. She's just too cute! Yeah, I'm fucking with you there, Athena. She's fucking adorable. So, have you always been in a wheelchair, Sarge? Negative. Only since I was injured. In the fire. Your voice sounds awfully different from before. My drone features a voice modulation device. It's just one of my army's many technological marvels. Well, you fooled me. I thought some 20-something military fanatic was out the controls. If it's all the same to you troops, I'd like to continue my testimony. She's fucking epic. You're awesome, army. I've just remembered something, and it's as crisp and clear as a trumpet at roll call. What did you remember? It wasn't my mother who appeared in the burning orb. It was some lady Papa had shown me a picture of a long time ago. He said it was the Holy Mother, the founder of Karateism. She appeared right there, right in the burning orb! Huh? What did you just say?! Well... that changes proceedings. The Holy Mother of Karateism was in the burning orb? What does that even mean? I have a bad feeling about this. Yeah, I think you just shot yourself in the foot there, buddy. Could it be? Could this explain what Sarge means by the Holy Mother appearing in the burning orb? That? What's that? Piece of okay, no. Right. Okay, right. Bollocks to that then. Ah. No, go back to fucking army. She's great. You really think a cockamamie plan would round the enemy? Yes, fine. Yikes, I'd better be more careful. If the orb was burning, maybe the evidence you're looking for has to do with thank you. No. Why do you keep putting me on the spot like this? I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Is there any fucking anything at all?
Is it the...
Dr. Buff's research notes? What do they have to do with this? Look at this, the burning orb, the appearance of the founder. This part points to both. There's a legend about the orb involving a mysterious riddle. And this song, in turn, is said to contain the key to solving it. If the legend is true, then I believe the answer lies in this part of the song. Offer thy prayers as fervent as fire, only then shall the Holy Mother return. Well, anyone see where I'm going with this? Prayers as fervent as fire. Ah! You're supposed to set the orb on fire? The whole stanza seems to suggest that the founder will appear if the orb is set on fire. Wait, so the doctor, he... Yes, Athena. He had solved the ancient riddle of the founder's orb. Oh, my! Well, why is that significant to you? I think that's kind of killed Phoenix's thing right fucking there. Papa was a great archaeologist. So I believe in him. And I want to believe. I want to believe he achieved his long-time dream of solving that riddle before he died. Well, we won't know for sure until we try it for ourselves. Yes, do it, Private Justice, please. I want to see what Papa was searching for with my own eyes. Fucking hell, how fucking dedicated was he? That was his long-time goal, really? Objection. The plaintiff must object to this. Yeah, you see, again, that's not fucking Phoenix. That's bullshit, man. He must have thought, oh yeah, no, let's go for it. What, he believes in justice. But no. He's like, oh, I've got a win for my clients. Like, you fucking know your client's talking out his ass. The plaintiff will stand down and be quiet. You don't have the right to set a precious relic like that on fire. Oh, but I do. All I needed was Sarge's permission. Since we still don't know if this treasure is the Founder's Orb or the Crystal of Amifei, any ownership rights the Doctor had now belong to his daughter. Therefore, you have absolutely no right to stop us! Gnyurk! Ah, fuck you, Phoenix. Very well, Mr. Justice, I never thought I'd be saying this, but you may burn the evidence. Alright, here we go. You gotta cover it in lighter fluid, or... Is it just ready to go? Look! Apollo, the inside of the orb! It's melting! There's something in there! Oh shit, it's even got a fucking face in it! Oh my god! Ah! Dirk, isn't she? Her garb leaves no room for doubt. It's the founder herself. Face and all. Oh, crikey, Moses. I don't understand. The greatest of taboos in Karaism is the depiction of the founder's face. Yet here it is. Hidden within this orb. Oh my god. Sorry, Mr. Wright, but as you can see, the issue is crystal clear. This figure is the Holy Mother, founder of Karanaism. And based on that, this must be none other than the Founder's Orb. But be that as it may, Mr. Arbalstall may have killed the Doctor. If so, it would render the orb transfer agreement null and void. Don't play dumb, Mr. Wright. The truth of the matter has already been proven. Dr. Buff wasn't killed right after Sarge saw Mr. Arable. It happened after the Doctor came back from hiding the orb. And you've no proof that Mr. Arable was still around at the time. Urgh. Your claim that the Defiant Dragons were behind the crime doesn't hold water. And that means the orb transfer agreement is still perfectly valid. Arrgh. Admit it, Mr. Wright. I just burned your whole case to the ground. Oh. No! Alright, that was pretty cool, I must say. But really, again, it's not fucking Phoenix, it's bullshit. Like, he... No, man. No. I reject that shit. That's not Phoenix fucking Wright. I won? I actually won? But Mr. Wright, would you care to respond? Respond? Alright, that's a bit more Phoenix-y, when he's sort of like, oh shit. I didn't think so. Wait, did we just win? Did we actually beat the Turnabout Terror? You're amazing, Apollo! Don't just stand there, right? Do something! Well, I don't think there's anything digging out of this hole. Mr. Attition, Attition Wimperson, I think it's time for your concession speech. I have proven beyond a shadow of a doubt that this is the Founder's Orb. The facts don't lie, but you obviously do. How's that for a campaign slogan? Well, why, you contemptuous peasant! Alright, that was fucking hardcore, I like that. I think this is a good time to wrap up this trial. If both parties have no further objections, I will render my verdict. No objections here, Your Honor. No... Oh my god! You can't do this! The crystal is mine! I'll lose the election if I lose that crystal! I'm sorry, but there's really nothing more I could do. You haven't forgotten about our little chat, have you? Oh shit! So that's why Phoenix was helping him out! What's going on here? Your Honor, I object to the defense's last claim. What? I don't believe they have truly proven that the relic is indeed the Founder's Orb. But we're like beyond a shadow of a doubt. Mr. Wright, I don't think even you could bluff your way out of this one. What possible argument could you have to claim that this isn't the Founder's Orb? About that. Oh, of course! He can't possibly have hit on something. The defense's assertion is incomplete. And this is why. The defense is basing their claim that this relic is the Founder's Orb on a legend. And that legend claims that the Founder will return when the riddle is solved at last. Right. And that's what happened. The Founder was revealed for all to see. But Mr. Justice, what about the rest of the legend? Huh? According to the legend, once the Founder returned, she would bestow spiritual power onto the person who solved the riddle. What? You're kidding, right? Well, Mr. Justice, do you feel great spiritual power coursing through your veins? No. But receiving spiritual powers and stuff, it's all just mystic mumbo-jumbo, right? Maybe so, but you're the one basing your claim on said legend. But, come on, man! And what we saw here does not fully fulfill it, does it? No, but... Consequently, you cannot rightfully claim that this is the Founder's Orb. That is, quite frankly, the biggest crock of all shit, but alright. What's going into him? Why is Mr. Wright doing this? It would appear that Mr. Wright has lost a few of his marbles. That couldn't be further from the truth, Your Honor. In any case, I believe this is a good time for a recess. Both sides will have 20 minutes to prepare. I ask that all arguments be ready by then. Oh, and Mr. Wright, you'd do well to wash up and find your missing marbles by then too. Well, I told you there was some weird ulterior bullshit going on behind him. At least we know now, but yeah. I mean, he's had to defend people in sketchy ways like that before, but it's like, he said it was strictly business and stuff, and really, it's like you couldn't find a spare, like, 2 minutes to go talk to Apollo and be like, yeah, the reason I'm doing this is because he kind of blackmailed the fuck out of me, so, you know... help a brother out. Mr. Wright is sure acting funny. I mean, he's famous for going out on a limb, but that last assertion was just plain crazy. It's either a bluff or a Hail Mary. Either way, it doesn't make much sense. Maybe there's something we're missing here. Although, he seemed perfectly normal when we spoke earlier. Apollo, I have a bad feeling about this. I'm gonna go check up on him. What's going on with you, Mr. Wright? Hey, Private Justice. Yay! She's fucking great. I like her. Oh, Sarge! I forgot to mention something. On the night of Papa's murder, a strange thing happened. Oh? But why are you only telling me about it now? Well, I didn't say anything before because I thought Papa's death was an accident. But now that we know otherwise, I figured it might be important. There's still more to this case? When I left my room and lost consciousness, I passed out right here. That's right above the coffee bar. Mm-hmm. But when I came to, someone was pushing my wheelchair. What? I was so scared, I beat a hasty retreat as fast as my wheels could take me. Do you know who it was? No, it was pitch black. Plus, I fled to my room so fast, I didn't even have a chance to turn on the light. Maybe it was your father. No, he would have said something to me. Besides, I'd have known if it was him. So then, it could have been your father's real killer? My thoughts exactly. But you didn't report this to the police. It didn't even occur to me. It's okay, you were obviously still upset, so don't beat yourself up over it. Apollo, this could be really important information. I think the act of pushing Sarge's wheelchair could be part of some bigger scheme. It's hard to see why else the killer would have done such a thing. Guess I should take her statement down as evidence. Oh, good. Oh, welcome back, Athena. Aww. What's with the long face? How'd it go with Mr. Wright? What should I... Athena? Oh, sorry! Zoned out there for a sec. The recess is almost over, so let's go! Ha ha ha! What was that all about? Oh dear. Oh dear. What's going on? Oh, I like it though. I like the intrigue. I like the intrigue. I do. Yes, it's lovely. Rabble. All right, court is once again back in session. Now, Mr. Wright, about that last objection you raised. We, the plaintiffs, still believe that the defense has yet to sufficiently prove its case. They claim that, according to legend, the Founder's Orb would bestow spiritual power. Yet the relic in question has failed to do so, therefore it has failed its own test. I see. He's sticking with that ridiculous argument? Furthermore, even if it is the Founder's Orb, it can't be awarded to the Defiant Dragons. After all, they were the ones who killed Dr. Buff. I thought we'd fucking disprove that one. What are you talking about? That was already proven to be false. There are no grounds for asserting that the Defiant Dragons murdered the Doctor. Oh, but I'm afraid there are, Mr. Justice. Your Honor, I would like to present new testimony to this court. Testimony that will show that Dats Arable did, in fact, kill Dr. Buff. What? Very well, you may call your witness. I guess Mr. Wright found another new angle. What new testimony could there be this late in the game? Really? Fellow citizens, it is I, politician, the once and future representative of the people. Jeez, not him again. My client divulged new information to me during the recess. He remembered something he saw, you see. Something crucial to this case. How very convenient. Yeah, I'm with you there, buddy. Oh, man. I'm starting to lose my fucking voice. I've been recording this since, what, two?
Fucking hell.
That's crime. It was around 11 at night, and I was out on a mobile meet and greet around the village. That's when I saw Dr. Buff being murdered from outside his study window. Mr. Arable snuck up from behind and struck him on the head. His weapon of choice? A suitcase. A big, strong man like him could easily swing a heavy suitcase into someone's head. Hey? You saw the murder as it happened? And you're just telling us now because... Heh, heh, heh. I saved the best for last. It's a tactic known to all the political greats. The murder weapon was a complete mystery, but my client's eyewitness account has finally brought it into the light. According to the autopsy report, Dr. Buff was struck in the head by the corner of some object. I suppose that could very well be the corner of a suitcase. But eyewitness testimony isn't the same as hard evidence. Oh, I wouldn't worry about that if I were you. What's that supposed to mean? We have physical evidence too. A luminol test revealed. Oh, fuck it out, really? The doctor's blood on Mr. Arable's suitcase. Really? But how does that prove Mr. Arable used it as a weapon? You should know the answer to that, Mr. Justice. Since you know as well as I that the suitcase is covered in his fingerprints. Ah! I forgot we dusted it right in front of Emma. Yeah, but that was on a sticker! Come on, man! The turnabout terror strikes again. This is quite convincing testimony and evidence. Nevertheless, you may proceed with your cross-examination, Mr. Justice. Well, that's a mighty fine pickle!
Oh dear.
God, what a dick, man. Around 11 at night, and I was at a mobile meet and greet around to fuck off. You're on a so-called mobile meet and greet at 11 at night. That's right. It's the perfect time because everyone is at home. You should have seen how the villagers' eyes teared up when they heard what I had to say. With tears of frustration, no doubt. You weren't riding around in your palanquin? That's right. Some village idiot reported me to the police. I'd been banned from using it after dark. No wonder, what with all the noise he makes. So what exactly did you see then?
That's when I saw Dr. Buff being murdered from outside his study window.
Sounds like you witnessed something rather shocking. Indeed. I didn't even believe it at first. I mean, a vicious murder in Karain? There haven't been many murders there, I take it. If I'm elected, I promise you that such a terrible tragedy will never happen again. A vote for me is a vote to banish murder forever from our beloved Karain village. Yeah, good luck with that. Mr. Titian Wimperson, please tell the court what you saw at the scene of the crime. Mr. Arable snuck up from behind and struck him on the head. He snuck up from behind? So you're saying the doctor never even realized Mr. Arable was there? That's right. He was utterly absorbed in a book. I see. What did you see Mr. Arable do next? He climbed up the bookshelf ladder and dumped a bunch of books down on the body. I believe he was trying to make it look like an accident. But that idiot didn't realize I could see everything from outside the window. One of those statements doesn't feel right.
Your Honor, I believe the witness made an important statement just now about how...
Dats is an idiot.
Quite like that, actually.
Ooh, yes! Yes, 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 yes. With you on board, got it, in the bag. The doctor was reading a book at the time of the murder. That's vital testimony. Very well, the witness will please add that statement to his testimony.
The doctor was standing in front of the bookshelves, absorbed in a book. No, he fucking wasn't, you slimy little brick.
Objection. The doctor was standing in front of the bookshelves, absorbed in a book, you say? I'm sorry, but it seems your testimony is completely unreliable. That's quite a bold statement. Well, let's hear you back it up. I challenge you to prove that I'm anything but 100% reliable. Okay, it would be my pleasure. Lately, it seems the Doctor's eyes had gotten so bad he needed reading glasses. However, his reading glasses were over on his desk. So you see, there's no way you could have been reading in front of the bookshelves. Hurrah! I'm sorry, Mr. Attishan Wimperson. God, that name is fucking... it's getting me now. But I'm gonna have to ask you to explain this discrepancy to the voting public. Yeah, gah, gah, gah. You what? I'll explain it, you lowly cur. I simply made a mistake, you see. The Doctor was actually sitting at his desk when Mr. Arable hit him over the head. But then the Doctor would have been facing him. Surely he would have seen him and tried to run. Dr. Buff was nodding off. I could tell because his eyes were closed and he wasn't moving. Sounds more like what you would do. Then how do you explain the fact that he was struck in the back of the head? Isn't that something that should be impossible from the front of the desk? Oh, about that. He bowed his head when he nodded off. That's when he was clobbered. So that's what you saw. Well, Mr. Justice, that sounds like a perfectly reasonable explanation to me. Do you have a problem with the proposal that the Doctor was struck while nodding off? Do I?
I don't know. I don't know. Kind of.
Because his book was stained with coffee. There is a problem. A very big problem. The witness's statement doesn't hold up under the slightest bit of scrutiny. Is that so? Then will you please show this court what evidence you have to justify this? Gladly, Your Honor. This shows the problem with the witness's claim that he saw the Doctor nodding off.
Does it? I'm gonna roll with my coffee then. Nope, wasn't it?
Fine then. I don't know. It was stained with coffee. I was kind of, you know, thinking that might be a thing.
Oh, by the way, I completely forgot to mention, when I fucking lost the case, there was actually an interesting little, like, after bit where Apollo talked about how, the Rebellion died because he lost the orb and, his relationship with Felix was really fucking awkward after that. I completely missed that bit, sorry. But it is there. There is a fail state, which is actually kind of cool.
Anyway, just thought I'd point that out. Think about the relative positions of the witness and Doctor again. That's where we'll find the contradiction. Justice, see that you avoid... okay.
Oh, he saw the door. He saw the door. Okay, alright, fine. I was thinking, fucking, because his book was stained with coffee, I'm like, well, he wouldn't nod off. Sorry.
Yep, with you on that. Coolio.
A diagram of the study? Mr. Attishan Wimperson allegedly viewed the murder from here. After staying there for like an hour. What the fuck? And the Doctor was allegedly nodding off. Here. But from his vantage point, the bookcase would have blocked the witness's line of sight. Why, yes, I believe you're right. But... ah! Objection! The fact remains, my client knew that the suitcase was the murder weapon. So he definitely has first-hand knowledge of the crime scene.
Yeah, that doesn't help you.
I'm afraid I have to agree with you there, Mr. Wright. But then we have to ask ourselves, from what vantage point did he see the murder? What are you insinuating, Mr. Justice? From what vantage point could Mr. Attishan Wimperson have seen the dozing Doctor? Once we determine that, I believe we'll finally see the truth behind this incident.
The witness saw the murder from right here. Oh, we actually rock and rolling with the fact that... Okay. That might be it, actually, because move the wheelchair.
You've got to be kidding. But that's... It is indeed. But everything only makes sense if the witness was there in the study. Inside the study? But that's the scene of the crime! I know. Mr. Atchison Wimperson, the man who claims to be a witness to the murder, was most certainly in that very room. Apollo, are you suggesting? Mr. Atchison Wimperson! Weren't you the one who actually swung that suitcase? Gah! What you're proposing is ludicrous! My client is a small, thin man, whereas Mr. Arable has the musculature to pull it off. He has a point. I gave up trying to lift that thing after one go. That's right, he's the only one who could have lifted such a heavy object. Now do you understand? The rebel Dats Arable is the Doctor's killer. As long as the suitcase is the murder weapon, the suspicion falls entirely on Dats. You'll have to poke a hole in Mr. Wright's argument somehow, Apollo. Oh, I will, and with his own technique, no less. If Mr. Atchison Wimperson couldn't swing the suitcase around, we'll just have to consider another way he could have used it as a murder weapon instead. I'm gonna turn this case on its head, Mr. Wright, just like you taught me. You talk big, Mr. Justice, but do you have what it takes? Well, this should be interesting. Mr. Atchison Wimperson's testimony has been filled with one inaccuracy after another. First he stated that Dr. Buff was in front of the bookshelves. Now he claims that the doctor was sitting at his desk. So where was the victim really when he was killed? Also, where was his killer? And how was the murder weapon really used? So the important thing here is the position of the victim and killer relative to each other? Yes, Your Honor. If they were positioned in a certain way, it would be possible to use the suitcase as a weapon without lifting a finger. He dropped it on his head. You can't mean! I would ask the court to recall the study's layout. It would also explain the coffee. Maybe. I'm still holding on to that. It made sense in my head, dammit. It's quite distinctive, as you can see. Now, if Dr. Buff was sitting in a certain spot and his killer was at a certain other spot, the suitcase would become a weapon anyone could use. Very well, Mr. Justice. Where was Dr. Buff's killer at the time of the crime? Eh? Now we well established that. Well, there. There? Oh, that's... This should wrap things up nice and pretty for you, Mr. Wright. I would ask the court to recall the study's layout. But this time, instead of thinking in two dimensions, let's think in three. Only then can we clearly see the killer's method at work. Alright, so... When I clicked it the first time, it was basically just saying, oh, look, you clicked inside the study, well done, you clever man. But here it was like, where was he actually? I'm like, oh, geez, where I clicked, you fuckers. The killer didn't have to swing the suitcase. If he used gravity to his advantage, that is. That's right, it was the plaintiff, one Paul Atchison Wimperson, who used the suitcase. He pushed it from the second floor and sent it hurtling down onto Dr. Buff, who was sitting at the coffee bar. That's like a one in a million shot, come on. Yah! The psychology book has been at the coffee bar, no doubt. The doctor must have sent it down there after he'd finished reading it, or the like. But his blood got onto it. Which is why the killer thought to hide it in that mountain of books. That's quite an entertaining theory you have there, Mr. Justice. But there's no evidence that the murder took place at the coffee bar. I'm not so sure about that, Mr. Wright. I'd say that evidence of the murder occurring at the coffee bar...
Whoa. considering you just said you're not sure.
The evidence does exist, and I'm gonna show you. You are? Oh yeah, the fucking coffee stain! Yes, fuck you, you're onto something. This brown stain was determined to be coffee. What's more, it was still a bit damp when we saw it yesterday morning. Ah! One look at this book speaks volumes, I'm afraid, Mr. Wright. Oh, this music is fucking epic. It tells us the doctor was having a cup of coffee at the coffee bar. Fuck is a coffee bar at their own fucking house? That's when the suitcase came hurtling down, striking him on the head. Causing both his blood and his coffee to spatter onto it. Ack! Ah! Well, Mr. Atchison Wimperson! What motive could I have possibly had to kill Dr. Buff? And there it is, that final excuse cornered killers are so fond of. Well, the doctor never returned your crystal to you, did he? Instead, he hid it in the cave ruins. Grr. Telling him that the Defiant Dragons were a dangerous bunch was a huge blunder. All it did was make him hide the orb. Your lie came back to bite you in the end. Ugh! Even worse, the Doctor saw the news report, so he knew the Relic was the Founder's Orb. Being the conscientious researcher he was, he knew he had to return it to its rightful place. And that meant keeping it out of your hands. Ah! You were so angry that he refused to return the Relic to you. That you killed him with your own hands! Isn't that right, Mr. Atchison Wimperson? Ah! Oh wow, it's not looking good for him. That is... Oh shit! How can you still have more? Apollo! Don't! Please don't accuse my client of- Oh my god, really? Alright, no, he is in some shit. Don't! Please don't accuse my client of murder. Huh? What do you mean, don't accuse him? Why would you even say that, Mr. Wright? What I meant was, he's a promising politician with a bright future ahead of him. It's in our nation's best interest to avoid burdening him with the taint of scandal. Say what? Right! You'd better do something to change the current courtroom climate, or I'll be charged with murder. And you know what will happen to her if- Oh my god, no! Arrgh. What's he talking about? Well, I can ponder that later, for now. Mr. Wright, you can't possibly believe that Mr. Arvel is the killer. Are you really going to send an innocent man to prison? I thought you were better than that. Well, Mr. Wright, answer me! Mr. Wright? What in the world's going on here? If you won't say anything, then... Mr. Atchison Wimperson, the defense hereby accuses you- Oh, Jesus. Apollo, wait! Not you too, Athena! It's just, I wasn't sure whether I should say anything, but during that last recess, when I went to check on Mr. Wright, I overheard something I shouldn't have. I trust Maya is on- Oh my fucking god! Oh, it's all gone tits up! I can't really say, but just remember, if I'm arrested or fail to obtain the treasure, there will be consequences. Consequences of the worst kind, if you catch my drift. Ah! Relax, all you have to do is ensure I get my hands on that relic. I must deliver it to my benefactor at all costs. What do they want that relic for anyway? It's something to do with an old legend. My patron seeks the great power said to be granted to whoever solves its secret. Oh man, this is brutal. Maya? As in Maya Fey? Yes, the boss's legendary former assistant. Miss Fey's being held hostage? So it seems. Why didn't you tell me as soon as you heard this? Sorry, it's just Mr. Wright spotted me before I could slip away. And maybe promised not to tell you. He said it would make things more difficult if you found out. Oh, as if things weren't already hard enough! So that's why Mr. Wright was acting so strange. Oh, man. Why is Maya always a fucking damsel in distress, for fuck's sake? I had no idea. This must have been excruciating for him. Think, Justice. There's got to be something you can do. Mr. Justice, about that last statement of yours. I believe you're in the middle of accusing the plaintiff of murdering Dr. Buff. Would you care to continue? Ah, aye. Yeah, I'm sorry, Apollo. I'm really, really sorry. What's gone into you two? If I accuse that slime bag, I put Miss Fey's life in jeopardy. It seems you've finally caught on. I'm far too important to be accused of murder. After all, our nation's future rests squarely on my shoulders. Either I give up, or... Once I present the crystal to my patron, my victory is assured. Then, one day, I'll become president, and then, king! I'll have every politician at my command! Now retract your accusation! I can't count out of him, but... The defense would... It would like to retract... the previous sec... Oh my fucking god! It's a roller coaster ride of pain! Apollo. The Dirk? I don't know what's going on here, but a lawyer should never look the way you do right now, with defeat and resignation written all over your face.
A dragon never yields.
Oh. Even when wounded, a dragon bites down hard, and never lets go until its dying breath. It glares, it roars, and it latches its jaws firmly onto its prey till the bitter end. That's what lawyers do to get the truth. Dirk, a dragon never yields. He's right. It's all over if I give up now. If Mr. Wright's hands are tied, it's up to me to do what must be done. He's saved my neck so many times. Now, it's my turn to save his! Dirk, thanks for that wake-up call. Heh, now that's the face of a lawyer you've got there, son. Where there's a will, there's a way. To do what? And I'm gonna find the way to save Miss Fey and see that justice is served. You are? Oh, Jesus! Alright. That scumbag is holding Miss Fey hostage to ensure he gets the orb for his patron. And it seems said patron believes in the orb's legend. Thing is, the founder did appear when the orb was exposed to fire, just as the legend said. If the legend is true, then we've already solved the riddle, right? No, not yet. The legend says the founder will bestow great spiritual power when she returns, but if that's true, it means we haven't solved the whole riddle yet. But how can that be? Are we missing something? Wait, maybe. Maybe the part about the founder returning should be taken literally. But how would it be possible for a dead person to return to the world of the living? Time travel! Oh shit, because they've seen her face, so they know what she looks like with you on board. Oh, I know, there is a way for the dead to return. Spirit channeling. Of course, you'd have to know what the founder looks like first. But the orb has revealed her face to us, so what if it's a sign that we should channel her? Given the facts, in order to solve the riddle and receive the Founder's power, I'd need a spirit medium. The ability of a medium to channel spirits is the final key to unlocking the orb's secret. That means Mr. Attishan Wimperson's patron will need one too, and once that slimy politician realizes that, he won't be able to lay a finger on Miss Faye. Oh yeah, it's fair point well made. But we kind of know who the patron is, so... Everything's gonna be okay, Mr. Wright, because Mr. Politician Wimperson can't afford to harm a hair on Miss Faye's head. Huh? Mr. Attishan Wimperson! It seems you've chosen the wrong person to take hostage. What do you mean? Your patron seeks to solve the orb's riddle, and thereby receive great spiritual power. However, only Maya Faye can truly give them what they really want. She can? What do you mean, only Maya Faye? Think about what the return of the Founder really means. We should have considered it more literally. After all, the orb was made in the Kingdom of Kharayan, the birthplace of spirit mediums. Ah, I think I see now. You need to know what the deceased looks like in order to channel them. But in Kharayanism, depicting the face of the Founder is taboo. However, her true face was hidden in the orb. So maybe the orb is telling us to try channeling the Founder. Exactly. For a spirit medium, the Founder can quite literally return. And if the legend is true, the Founder just might bestow spiritual power on someone when she does. It's like when Pearls imbued my Magatama with spiritual power. If a human could be imbued with such power in a similar manner, it is said the Founder possesses immense spiritual power. Such a great feat would not necessarily be beyond her. Well, wait a second! The legend is true? Do you understand now, Mr. Attishan Wimperson? You are holding hostage the final key to unlocking the orb's secret. And if anything were to happen to her, the riddle would remain unsolved forever. Ah! Oh man, this fucking game. I like that, it's a cheeky way of looking at it. There's always Pearl Faye! I could simply ask her to help. If she wants money, I have plenty to offer. She's not the kind of person to be tempted by material gain, and she certainly wouldn't help you if anything were to happen to her cousin. Urgh. Or maybe you'd like to go ask the Queen of Kharayan to channel the Founder for you. He could, but he'd probably get executed for requesting such a thing. It's over. Now confess, you killed Dr. Buff, didn't you? Ah! Urgh. It wasn't supposed to end this way! Mr. Attishan Wimperson, are you admitting to committing the crime? You're my lawyer, right? Do something! It's true that I'm your lawyer, and as such, it's my job to defend you. However, defending my client isn't the only duty a lawyer has. There's something else that's equally as important. And that is finding the truth. Yeah, he's back! See, again, it's like the one time you go up against him, and it's like, oh, I was being fucking colluded, I have to be a prick. It's like, nah, man, I ain't about that. They could have made that into just something on its own, and it would have been awesome. But what? Mr. Attishan Wimperson, you have sought to twist the truth in the dirtiest of ways. I was complicit in your hostage-taking, but in a way, I was being held hostage too. And even so, there's still hope for me to make things right. And I owe it all to you, Apollo. Yeah! Mr. Wright. I can't allow a murderer to walk away scot-free. Therefore, Mr. Attishan Wimperson, I must resign as your attorney. No, 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 no! Does this mean... I'm under arrest? No! Well, I've nothing to confess. What? I said I've nothing to confess! I don't and I won't, especially not to a plebeian like you! This guy doesn't know when to give up. Besides, there's no truth to these allegations. I mean, look at the suitcase. You won't find a single print of mine on it. All that means is, you wipe them off, taking care to only leave Mr. Arables. That makes sense and is actually mildly consistent with what happened, or what we found. As many a great politician has said before me, no comment. In that case, try switching things up, Apollo. Look at the situation from a different angle. Is there really nothing that points to the suitcase being dropped from up above? Evidence that points to the suitcase being dropped from the second floor. If the killer pushed the suitcase from the second floor hallway over the coffee bar, that would place him right around here. Ah, maybe. Just maybe. Thought of something, Apollo?
This piece of evidence to be connected to the dropping of the suitcase. I'm assuming that will be Army's statement. Yup.
That appears to be a statement, but how is that related to this case? On the night of the murder, Your Honor, Miss Army Buff physically left her room. That's when she saw the doctor burning the orb and subsequently passed out, right above the coffee bar. But with her there in the wheelchair, or in her wheelchair, the killer wouldn't have been able to drop the suitcase down onto the doctor. Good point! However, according to Sarge, she woke up just as someone was trying to move her in her wheelchair. Ah! Oh, she's fucking great. You're awesome. It's flashback.
Someone was pushing my wheelchair. What? And this girl be a hasty retreat. None of my wheels could take me.
Flash forward. She's fucking... She just looks cool. She must have been in the killer's way and had to be moved. Isn't that right, Mr. Attish and Wimperson? Can we, like, shorten it? It's a bit of a bastard to say. It's a good name, though. Arg! And if the killer had pushed the whole wheelchair with his bare hands, we may yet find the conclusive evidence we need. Exactly. Fortunately for us, that evidence slipped right through the killer's fingers. If only he'd been able to hold onto it just a little tighter. But now he is neither able to discard nor alter it. Honestly, that piece of evidence wasn't even supposed to be here in this courtroom today. And yet, it looks like sometimes things do get better. This wasn't supposed to happen. No? Well, too bad, because the evidence that sped away from you that night has come back to haunt you, right here at this very trial. Your Honor, the defense's final piece of evidence is on this person. That's... On the night of the murder, Sarge passed out, only to come to and find that someone was pushing her wheelchair. That's when she fled back into her room. She didn't physically see a single soul after that. Not until Athena drew her out through that therapy session, that is. While the killer was able to wipe the prints on the suitcase, the same can't be said for the prints that got away. My fellow Karainians. Well, Mr. Politician Wimperson, try and explain your way out of this one. The podium is all yours. Politician, saver of Karain. I am not a crook. My political career, it can't end like this. I'm destined for great things. Something's wrong. This isn't real. It's a dream. No, it's... Oh, Jesus. Huh? What? Wait, really?
Whoa, no way!
Banza? Wait, what? No, please! Wait! Don't go! No, no, please! Whoa, Grandpa! Fucking hell, we put a giant abyss under the podium. Oh, he's just gone fucking mad. That was cool. Mr. Attishan Wimperson, are you alright? Bailiff, get him to the first aid station, on the double. Well, this was yet another unexpected turn of events. Just a scotch. Just a little bit. In light of everything that's been revealed, it seems the relic is indeed the Founder's Orb. And it seems Mr. Politician Wimpersome can be considered a suspect in Dr. Buff's murder. Apollo, I want to thank you for everything. Thanks to you, I didn't have to keep bending the truth. I don't know what I would have done without you. Don't mention it. You're amazing today, Apollo! Well, I couldn't have done it without Dirk. Flashback.
A dragon never yields.
Yeah, thank you. Even when wounded, a dragon might sound hard, and never has glared to this time wrath. It glares, it roars, it farts a lot, and then it falls asleep, very drunk. That's what lawyers do to get the truth. A dragon never yields. Every lawyer should take that to heart. As it seems both sides have no further objections, would Dark Sard Marty please take the stand? This court awards the orb to the Defiant Dragons per the stated transfer agreement. Yay! Well, I suppose it still eventually turned out to be a murder, sort of. Well, actually, they only got as far as accusing him of murder. Should the Kingdom of Karain claim ownership, the matter may have to be deliberated in court all over again. I just hope, or shall I say pray, that I'm not the judge presiding over that one. Indeed, a trial like that might spark an international incident. Still, there are bigger and more momentous things astir in the air. The revolution. Dirk's really serious about this. This court is adjourned. Well, we still haven't quite solved the overarching problem, but at least he's not going to be killed. So, good job, I guess. Nice work, son! We've finally broken through the last obstacle on the road to revolution! There are police officers right fucking there! Revolution. It just doesn't seem real. Yes, well, to think you actually defeated the Fighting Phoenix. All I can say is, that's my boy! Ha 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 ha! Yeah, but he knew he was wrong from the start. It's not legit, man! Oh, it's not fair. Well, Mr. Wright did have his hands tied. Who knows if I'd have won if he'd been able to fight me head on. I see it more like you saved Mr. Wright. Saved him? Yeah, remember what he said? He didn't have to bend the truth anymore, and it was all thanks to you. I don't know about that. Still, I guess it is kind of nice to be appreciated. Mr. Dirk? Now that the Holy Mother's face has been revealed, are you going to have a spirit medium try channeling her? I, for one, would love to see the return of the legendary Founder. Yeah, just think about it, being able to speak to someone right out of the history books. Unfortunately, it's not that easy. What? Why? A face isn't enough. You also need the true name of the one you're attempting to channel. Alright, Pearl mentioned something like that. And the Founder's true name is only known to the priestess who's been crowned queen. In short, the only living person who knows it is the current queen of Karain, Garan. Oh, so without her help, we won't be seeing the Founder anytime soon. That's no fun. Hang on a minute. That doesn't bode well. So, Dirk, what will you do now? First, I'll start by tracing the route by which the orb came into Dr. Buff's hands. Since we now know it was Paul Attishan that asked the Doctor to study it, isn't he the one who stole it? No, a political nobody like him couldn't get anywhere near the orb, let alone steal it. He must have had inside help. My money is on someone connected to the royal family. Alright, you said something to that effect back in the cave. Wow, it didn't flash back to that? Fucking hell! Whoever it may be, we need to expose their dirty scheme to the light of day. Well, I'm sure Mr. Wright has plenty of information, courtesy of his dirty client. He might be able to shed some light on this. Private Justice! That was fine work you did at the trial today. You did your sergeant proud. Back at you, Sarge. It took real courage to leave your room like that. It's all thanks to you and core woman Sykes. With my siege defense over, I can finally sally forth. But the battle's only just begun. One for me and me alone to fight. To lose your mother, and then your father. What a terrible thing to endure. Yeah, and being wheelchair-bound doesn't help. Private Justice, I've been thinking. It's about time I stood on my own two feet. After all, I no longer have Papa to coddle me. Huh? I'm afraid I don't follow. Take a good look, soldier. This is one small step for man, and one giant leap for me. Hold my drone for me, would you, Private Justice? Yes, sir. What is she up to? Hunya! Whoa. Yay! She did it! She's standing? What's this? Sarge, you mean your legs? There. The doctor told me I was ready to walk again months ago, but if I admitted I could walk, I knew I'd have to leave the house. So I faked it. Makes sense, but I kept pretending I couldn't walk. But I know Papa is watching over me now, and I'd hate to disappoint him. So, from this day forth, I'm gonna march forward on my own two feet. What a brave kid, trying to move forward like this. You fucking cool, army! But it must be so hard this soon after a father's death. Don't you ever stop. You just keep on walking, comrade. Stay brave, because there will be days when you'll want to stop. But I have faith you'll find a way to muster the strength to push through them. Yeah, you can do it. Hey, Daddy's back! Oh, light it up, you bellend. Come on, the fat kid just decided to walk again. Give her a break. Put on a smile. Mr. Wright, what's that look on his face for? Oh, Apollo! Is everything alright with Miss Fay? She's safe, for now. Well then, we better go save her, quick! Where is she anyway? I'm afraid I have some bad news. Huh? Maya's not here in the States. She's still in Karine. And she's still being held hostage by the mastermind behind this whole thing. The mastermind? That's right. Paul Attisham Wimperson was nothing more than a pawn. Maya's true abductor is in the Kingdom of Karine. What? Well, I thought that was kind of obvious, but alright. I don't understand, Mr. Wright. What in the world's going on over there? Well, Phoenix did kind of rock the boat stupid hard. But as shocking as that news was, it was only the beginning. The beginning of something big. Big enough to shake Karine to its very core. Revolution. I was being swept up in a mighty wave that nothing could stop. Of course, at the time, I had no idea what the days ahead had in store for us. Oh, shit. Oh, man. I was... Well, alright, yeah, I was... I think I was right. I believe I talked about it. So... Basically, next case is gonna be it, guys. One last big spunky blowout where fucking everything's on the table. Everything's gonna be stupid hard. I'm gonna fuck all of it up, but it's gonna be epic. Oh, man. There's fucking... Oh, God. Alright, I need to... assume position.
I actually really like that, to be fair. I've kind of liked all of it since the first case. The first case really let itself down by just being, well, it wasn't even baby's foot. There were a few things I really fucked up on, but it's like the writing in that was terrible. And it's like, alright, I don't appreciate the constant soldier talk, and it gets a bit weird and a bit awkward at times, but it's like, I really kind of like that, sort of like, oh yeah, fucking armies, like, you know, just a kid, kind of fucked up, just trying to shut herself out of the world, and then it's like, oh yeah, I can do it. I don't think it would be quite that jarring. You wouldn't go from, oh, I don't want to face society and fucking everyone I love is dead to, yeah, I'll give it a go, in about an hour. But I still appreciate the the character. I thought it was quite good. I to be fair, I think fucking Paul the Titian Wimperson was pretty cool. To be fair to the guy, like, it's the most blatant on the nose, like, someone's literally firing a shotgun into your face with the point emblazoned on every single, like, ball bearing in the shell. And it's still kind of like, I still like it. It's just so fucking stupid. But I kind of appreciated it for what it was. I would really like to know, like, if there was ever developer commentary for whoever did that character. I'd really like to know what exactly, because, like, oh yeah, politicians are slimy scumbags, I get that. But it's like, fucking hell. Basically created a politician that proclaimed himself as the next Jesus and thought that everyone loved him when they all fucking hated his guts and wished he would die. And in his own eyes, he could do quite literally no wrong. It's that sort of thing where it's so blatant that it actually adds new depth to the guy, despite being the most shallow, just representation. It's just the new depth is just like, why is he so blatant and rammed down your throat? But I really liked it. So yeah, that was another good one. Like I say, I think my main disappointing point was, it's like, they fucking big it up like, oh yeah, it's Apollo versus Phoenix is gonna be epic and legendary, and you're not playing as Phoenix. But, you know, it's still, you know, like, the young buck versus the sagely master. And then it's like, it wasn't really, like, alright, yeah, he had, like, they wrote it so he had a reason to act the way he did. And I get that, and I appreciate that. But it's like, well, if he's not acting like Phoenix Wright, and he's basically being blackmailed into being a prick, it's like, well, it's not the same thing, is it? Like, the first time in any fucking game that you face Phoenix Wright, it's the first time Phoenix Wright has lost, although he resigned as the lawyer, so I don't know if he lost. I suppose on a technicality he didn't. And, you know, like I say, it was just kind of ruined because they had to write it so that he didn't mean to be like that, whereas I still think there's genuine mileage in having him, you know, having you go up against him in an actual, like, thing. I would quite like to see that. But on the other hand, the other problem you've got with that is that you know you're going to win. I mean, even in that case with Maya, when you lost, you still came back and won. It's like, it's, yeah. Like, I think there's genuine mileage in that, and there's a good story to that, and, like, say, you know, a newfound respect would come from peers having to duke it out in a court of law. But I don't know, I feel like that was sort of wasted. If anything, doing it from Phoenix's point of view might have actually been kind of cooler, because Apollo kind of spanked him into the ground. I mean, Apollo was the one who had to kind of, you know, flip it round at the end so that Maya wasn't immediately killed. But it's like, doing it from Phoenix's point of view, where he is being blackmailed, but then he's also up against a colleague who he respects, and he's also mentored, so he's, like, trying to, you know. There were many different ways you could have played that, and I feel like they kind of picked the shittiest option on the table. It didn't play out badly, but it didn't play out like Phoenix Wright versus Apollo. But other than that, the rest of it was great. I really liked it. Like, again, like, wait, so it's basically, it's got 4 out of 5 for me. because the first case was just... I don't know, the first case wasn't bad, but it, again, the problem that I keep bringing up is kind of 90% of it. It's kind of kneecapped itself. It doesn't matter how good the rest of it is, the writing in that first chapter was fucking terrible. Anyway! Oh, I have no idea when I'm going to play this again, but I really want to fucking play it some more. It's just fun. You know what it is? It's fun. When fucking... You know, I don't know. I haven't even fucking rendered this or started uploading it, so I have no idea what the reaction to it is. Like, I could upload the first part of me narrating it, and you'll be like, what the fuck are you doing? But it's like, I don't give a shit. Like, I kind of knew that when I started recording this, that this was just going to kind of be for me. And I enjoy it. And I hope you all enjoyed it as well, up to this point, of just me just narrating it with random bits of rambling thrown in, because I fucking love this shit. It's just fun. It knows what it is. And it's okay with that. And it goes with it. Anyway, I will shut up. And I will be blueballing myself until I get the time to do it again. Unfortunately, I get the horrible feeling that the next time I'm going to have time for it is in my 10 days off. That's 2 weeks away. So, yes, I'm gonna be very, very sad. I'm just going to have to try and find the time for it, because I need to play this more. I want to finish it, just so it's complete in my brain. Anyway, I hope you've all enjoyed, and I look forward to seeing you all for the final episode. In a bit. Peace.